considered a feat of its own as the spread of the novel coronavirus skyrockets across the country. Most people are desperate for some survival stories. We bring you faces from Toro who caught COVID and managed to soldier through it. They also have some encouraging words for those that are battling the illness and those that are taking care of the patients.
James Mujenyi, a minister without portfolio in Toro Kingdom, recalls his tough experience after contracting the coronavirus. His first test was negative, but still he experienced signs and symptoms of COVID-19. He suffered high and cold body temperature, lost his appetite, and could not taste or smell anything. A second test revealed that he was positive, and he was treated at Mulago Hospital.
COVID victim in November. But during that first wave, it was dangerous. It actually tortured me. I thought that was my time now to die. Unfortunately or fortunately, it was negative at that time. But I continued presenting symptoms of COVID until a time when I could not breathe anymore. I had to be put on oxygen, life support machines, and referred to Kampala.
For Patrick Musana, the Kabarole Hospital Finance Officer, it was a psychological battle. He had seen many people die from the illness, but he did not lose hope. He isolated at home and managed to beat the virus.
I really got fear because, one, I had gotten experience from other people who had died. I had seen my friends dying. I had seen people within the hospital where I worked from were seriously sick, and others were coming and then die. So that one was a fear. But when I realized that, one was I had some people who were having still experiences what they have, who had gone through the same experience, and therefore when I heard about those people telling me that, then they said you can still concentrate.
Another COVID survivor says he infected 4 family members. He had to stay away from his children as he recovered. He tells the story.
They suspected, because I had been in contact with them, my wife in the same room, even beyond, we could be in the same bed. So all of them have got the infection, have been infected. They were subjected to testing without showing the signs. Now, all of them were tested. I have a family of 6 people. Only my wife was negative.
It was a challenge to my home because I have a family of 5 children and my wife. And of course, when they heard about, they were also in detention. But what I did was to have a place where I would sit in during the day, like in the compound. I would keep the mask on. I would keep every place with washing places where people would wash.
Stigma is another thing that COVID survivors have to battle. Members of the community often are afraid to go near them.
They were talking about the effects of COVID. After COVID, I don't have any. The most that I was fearing was that thing of saying you'll no longer be a man enough. In you know, when I talk of a man enough.
The time that it was so challenging was the time when I got free out of COVID. When they tested me negative, I was free to interact with people. I was free to move in my office. But this is when I realized that people were still distancing themselves from me.
James Mujenyi narrates that at Mulago Hospital, where he was treated, he saw the rich and the poor alike suffer from the illness. He warns that COVID is no respect of persons.
Moving in the ambulance, I was alone. When I was being admitted, I found a ward full of COVID patients. That one gave me hope. I said, if I'm to die, all these people will die. Rich and poor, all of them were in the same category.
Hopes were high in a way that after being educated, I realized that I still have to live a life. I still have to look after my family. And therefore, if I could neglect by all means and just misuse my life, I was going to die and my family would be in problem.
Mujenyi, on the other hand, encourages Ugandans to take personal responsibility in the fight against COVID. He says the rate at which people are being infected is too high for the government alone to manage. The survivors have some advice for Ugandans.
COVID is real, it is there. We are living with it. But my advice is concentrate on what is better for your life.
to observe the SOPs. People should wash hands. People should keep distance. People should avoid social gatherings.
Story by Doreen Nasima.